Buffer bashing. It was a windy day on the island of Sodal. Not too severe, but the engines took extra care just in case of an accident. Douglas was resting in a siding. He had finished his midday train and was waiting for his next train to be ready. A signalman had forgotten to switch the points to get to the station, so Douglas could couple up to his coaches, but he was just waking up. He started moving forward in the wind, pushing quite quickly. But nobody seemed to notice the buffers until it was too late. He was allowed to change some splinters, went everywhere. Douglas had bashed the buffers and his buffer beam was damaged. Percy had to take the train instead. In the sheds that night, Donald could only laugh.
Are we a bit of clumsy, eh?
Ark.
Well, never mind. I'll be more careful.
Douglas snorted crossly and went to sleep. The next morning, Donald woke up early and went into the sidings to fetch his train. It was very stormy that day, and Donald could hardly see through the rain as it pattered down on his smoke box. The rails were slippery and suddenly found that he couldn't stop.
Oh, what's happening? Brakes, driver?
His driver turned the handle, but nothing happened. Donald shut his eyes. Debris was everywhere, the buffers were absolutely destroyed. One of the workmen ran up to Donald.
Hours and hours of work gone in pieces because of your clumsiness, he shouted angrily.
Donald couldn't say anything. He was lost for words, but sneezed because some of the dust went up his throat. The flight controller had many words to speak with Donald. He wasn't angry, but he was firm. Donald and Douglas are more careful around buffers. What Bill and Ben like to call them, the buffer bashing, band breaking Scots. They think that Donald and Douglas deserve that. But I don't think they do. Do you?